Hello, I'm Al Karitz. Today I'd like to give you a brief overview of our EMS Quorum Q-Series benchtop coating tools. I'm going to use the QVES Plus as a template for this overview. They're all basically the same, but the vacuum and capabilities, as well as whether they can evaporate or sputter or both, is entirely dependent on what you need for your application and also fits your budget. The VES Plus that I have here is the pinnacle of the benchtop coating tools. So let's talk about this, and then we'll talk about what the difference is between the Q150 VES Plus, the Q150 TES Plus, or the Q150 RES Plus, the full range of the Q series, the 150 models. So the way they're separated into pumping abilities, as well as whether they can evaporate, they can sputter, or both, is delineated by the denoted by whether it has an R or a T, followed by an E or an S or an ES. A bit confusing, but I myself or any of the salespeople that you know can help you sort this out. This happens to be a VES Plus, which has a specially designed pumping system to give you a 1 × 10⁻⁶ millibar vacuum within typically 1 hour of you starting at the pump. The 150 TES or the 150 T series will give you a vacuum of mid to the middle of the 10⁻⁵ range in about an hour after startup. And then the 150 R series systems are rotary pumped, not turbo pump systems. Therefore, they're limited to the high 10⁻³ millibar range and not suitable for high vacuum applications. The 150 VS Plus will pump to 10⁻⁶ in about an hour. My demo system here, which I try to keep as pristine as possible, overnight has pumped to 4⁻⁷ millibar. Quite remarkable for a benchtop system without using any liquid nitrogen as a cold trap. It has a very specially designed pumping manifold that Quorum developed. These are some of the inserts that are common to all those systems, and I will talk about those in a moment separately. The 150T system, again, is mid 10⁻⁵ millibar range and is suitable for most laboratory coatings. However, if you wish to have high resolution coatings or high resolution carbon foils that are close to amorphous for making TEM substrates, you really should go for the VES system because that will allow you to sputter the finest grains possible on your sample, or to evaporate as close to amorphous carbon as you can get, so you can have very clean carbon coatings on your TEM grids. the 150T systems, ES, because of the vacuum is only mid 10 to the minus 5 range, the quality of the coating is somewhat degraded by the residual gases in the chamber. All of the sputtering and evaporation inserts are exactly identical. It all comes down to the quality of the vacuum during the process that determines the end result. The 150R is really only limited to a few basic metals to sputter. You can sputter silver, gold, gold palladium, and platinum in a 150R system. Whereas in the 150T, you have a wide range of metals, copper, titanium, ITO, chromium, tungsten, of course, iridium, platinum, a very wide range of metals. And this is because the vacuum is better. The VES, you can cover that whole gambit of materials, as well as some others, because the vacuum quality is quite good. There's a white paper that I can send you if you're interested. I will put my tag contact information on the end. I can send you a publication which shows the difference in the materials chosen to sputter, as well as the quality of the vacuum determines the end product. So that's all available. So now let's talk a little bit more about the common features between them, the totally independent of the vacuum system and its abilities. Primarily these three inserts and how quickly you can go from one to the other. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the system venting, and I'll come back when it's vented. It's just simply push of a button. There's a separate video on YouTube which discusses this whole graphic user interface for you. So I'll be right back. Okay, the system is vented. And I'll lift the lid and first show you the chamber. It's stopped and signaled that it completed the venting process. There's a separate video on the graphic user interface. It's all nicely menu driven and very easy and intuitive to operate. So. Here we have inside the chamber of the 150T VES Plus. It's configured quite the same across the different platforms, the 150R, the 150T, and of course the TES is a combination of evaporation and sputtering. So here you have your standard stage. There are some other stages that are available, including sort of a tumble stage, so you can coat samples that have high topography from as many angles as possible. This is a film thickness monitor. This is optional. I highly recommend it because it allows you to reproducibly recreate the same coating you did the last time and time again. Without it, we can get pretty accurate with some very precise gas controls because of the computer controls the sputter level, the gas level, and the sputter current also play a factor in the quality of your coating. So using the computer, we get very, very precise control over that. The vacuum, again, plays into this in a significant way. However, when you choose your system, you need to take this into consideration, how much resolution you really need, whether or not you're working with a field emission microscope or a tungsten microscope. Basically, if you're working with a tungsten microscope, you can probably just get away with a 150R system. If you have a field emission microscope and you want the top resolution that you can possibly achieve on any benchtop system, the 150 VES like we have here, if you're okay with middle of the road sort of resolution, the 150 T systems are perfectly okay for that. So film thickness monitor stage, it rotates. You can get a rotation tumble stage, you can get a stage to hold slides. There's a whole plethora of different stages that you can get. So let me put the glass bell jar back in place. Now let me show you up here. This is the sputtering arm or evaporation arm. If you pull this silver knob here in the front, you can detach the halves for sputtering. Well, you can change these inserts quite rapidly. Right now I have a platinum sputter head installed, so you just unplug this connector and lift it out, and I can go from platinum sputtering to carbon rod evaporation that quickly. Now these pins that are on the top, make with these switches here, it tells the system automatically what type of source head you have in there. Whether it be carbon rod like I just inserted, I just removed the sputter head, there's a carbon thread evaporation head. These pins are all in different positions. It's keyed to these switches, and it automatically tells the system what insert you've placed in the device, which makes it very easy for a multi-user facility for somebody to work with these. And then when you're done, the electrical contacts are made by either plugging the sputter head in here, as I just demonstrated when I removed it. The electrical connections for evaporation are made automatically. These two high current terminals get placed on those. It's locked into place, and it's sort of like lock and load. You're ready to roll here. There's a built-in shutter mechanism which prevents your sample from getting contaminants on it when you start the evaporation process. You degas your carbon sources, in this case carbon rods, or if you're sputtering a metal like chromium or tungsten, which is an oxidative type of metal, they build up oxides on their surfaces, so you want to remove those by pre-sputtering onto the shutter here, so you can't, you won't start putting those contaminants down on your sample. So again, you just lock the lid, you go over to the graphic user interface here. It has a list of recipes that are available to you. You pick the recipe that you're going to need for this particular process. You press the green arrow, the system will automatically start pumping, will automatically run the process for you, and vent the system at the end and beep, just like you heard here a moment ago when the system was vented. So we have two different carbon sources. We have a carbon rod source, and we have a carbon cord source. You use carbon cord is mostly for EDS work, so you just want to put down a nice fine layer of carbon to reduce charging. And of course, if you sputter a metal and you're looking on an EDS spectrum, for instance platinum peak would show up, and that may obscure some of the other peaks that you're looking for. So this is why carbon's used for EDS work. So you can put down a little carbon for most routine EDS work. Geologists like to do cathode luminescence, and they need a much heavier carbon coat, and carbon rod is very suitable for this because it can give you in excess of 25 nanometers of carbon in, you know, in one evaporative event. The carbon cord will give you, you know, approximately 15 nanometers of carbon on a regular basis. So that's why you would choose one or the other. And again, there's a video available that will show you the graphic user interface. You can pre-program your recipe for your coding process. It's very intuitive. It already has built into it a library of various materials that the system's able to coat with, and it plugs those parameters in, and you just have to, you know, fine-tune that recipe to your desire, time, thickness, different sputtering pressures or sputtering currents, whether or not you want the stage to rotate or not. You customize that. They're saved. There's a lot of memory. You can save a lot of them. The graphic user interface also has a logging function where it will log your process, and you can record or go back and look at those values that you did for a previous specimen. The 150 R systems have this, the 150 T systems and the 150 V systems all have these features that I just discussed. If you have any other further questions, you can reach me directly at EMS, and I'll put my contact info there, or contact one of our field sales guys. Thank you very much for your attention.